So hi everyone, today in this video I am going to tell you about how to participate in counseling in IISER 2025. So because a lot of students are asking, bhaiya please make a video how to participate or how to participate in counseling. Bhaiya I have low rank, so should I wait till last round? And bhaiya if I wait till last round, so how I can get participated in counseling? So in this video I'm going to tell you about each and every detail. So please watch the whole video and please subscribe my channel if you not have, and please follow me on Instagram because your support is very important for me. And please please support and subscribe my channel and follow on my Instagram account. Okay, if you have any query, please let me know on the comment box and Instagram DM and email also. My email ID amitiser241@gmail.com. This is my email ID you have to mail. Or if you want to mail my college email ID, which should I not recommend ki aap college email ID pe mail karo, because a lot of mail are coming from internal emails and external emails in my college ID, so I'm not going to reveal my college ID. By the way, amit21@iserb.ac.in, this is my college ID. But I will recommend you should mail me on amitiser241@gmail.com. Okay, I will answer this and I will sort out all the queries through this email. And one more thing, you also message me on Telegram also freely. So without wasting any time, let's begin. Basically, the IISER Aptitude Test 2025. Not in 2025, IISER counseling will be happen in very different way, like JOSA counseling, CSAP counseling, UPTU, HPTU, and a lot of counseling are very different way, but this counseling is different. In other counselings, you have to particularly participate and pay some money to participate in the counseling, pay some money to fill the choice filling, something like that. But in this counseling, you don't have to pay anything in the counseling. Okay, so I will explain you how the counseling in how will you participate in the counseling. Let's suppose Ram is a aspirant of IISER Aptitude Test 2025, and you will consider yourself. So you will appear in the 2025 examination, then you will got any rank. Let's suppose your all over rank is 672. Okay, and if you have belonged to any category, I don't consider any category in this situation. Right now I'm just going to explain how the counseling IISER have. Okay, I'm not going to explain category, rank and etc. Okay, you have to imagine and you have to calculate yourself. Okay, so the counseling will when your result come, when your scorecard coming, whatever result and scorecard, the same thing, when your scorecard is coming, and after your scorecard there is a particular day to fill the preference order. And I repeat, in previous video I also repeat and I must repeat in this video, please don't do any mistake in while filling the preference order, especially those students who got less than 100 marks. If you fill the wrong preference, then you will definitely lose your cutoff or lose your opportunity. Okay, when the preference order portal is open, I will especially make a 2 to 3 videos about this, how to fill the preference order. Okay, for the BTEC, for those who are interested in BTEC, for those who are interested in BSMS statistical sciences, for those who are interested in computational data sciences, for those who are interested in natural sciences, I will make all the videos regarding this. So please don't do mistake by filling the while filling the preference order. Okay, after filling the preference order, when you submit your preference order means which preference you want, which IISER which IISER first you will refer, like IISER Pune, if you refer, like you want IISER Kolkata, something. Okay, so let's suppose you fill the preference Pune, Kolkata, Bhopal, Mohali, Trivandrum, Tirupati and Bairampur. Okay, these are seven preference you have filled, but mostly not seven. This year you will more preference you have to fill. So seven preferences you have filled already and submit. After submitting the preference order, there is a special deadline announced by the official website, announced by Joint Admission Committee, JAC, when the counseling is started. When the first, so let's suppose the counseling date is 11th of July. Okay, 11th of July is the counseling date. So on 11th of July, you don't need to do anything. Okay, in 11th of July, it means 11th of July, your first round of allotment will be happen. And first round allotment will be, how will be happen? Like all the seven ISERs, all the JAC committee members, all the JAC, especially JAC committee, will consider some cutoff for the first round, not whole admission cutoff. No. If, like, let's suppose the first round cutoff is 430. Okay, so those who are belong to general category below greater than or equal to 430, then they will get admission, like they will allot a college in first round. Okay, while considering the preference order, let's suppose your rank is 122 all over. So they're seeing, oh, you are choosing first IISER Pune, then you will allotted IISER Pune. Or you are choosing IISER Bhopal first, you will Bhopal first. After first round, let's suppose remember my previous words, 642 is I assume rank. Okay, so first cutoff rank is 430 and your rank is 642. So you will not get any college in first round. But don't be panic. When the second round of allotment will be happen after a week, let's suppose 17th of July, for second round will be happen, then you will definitely get a college without doing anything. Okay, I think you are able to understand what I am trying to say. You don't need to anything. You just consider your you just see your result. After that, you pray and counseling is started. You don't need to anything. You don't need to participate. You don't need to pay anything, and you don't need to do choice filling. No, you just fill the preference order and that's relax and pray to God. I will get in college. Okay. Automatically all the things will happen. You don't need to anything after allotment. Like, you will get college in second round of allotment. You have got three options. First is accept and freeze, second is accept and float, third is reject. Accept and freeze means, let's suppose you have allotted you are getting IISER Bhopal in first round, or you are getting IISER Bhopal in second round. Let's suppose in first round IISER Bhopal. So in accept and freeze, you have to press the accept and freeze button and you have to pay 35,000 rupees. Those who are from belong to general OBC, EWS and PWD candidates, you have to pay 35,000 rupees for a seat acceptance fee. This fee you have to pay within the deadline, after deadline, because every round of allotment has some deadlines. Like, if the allotment is started on 11th of July, and maybe it will over 14th of July. Before 14th, you have to pay your seat acceptance fee. After that, if you not pay your seat acceptance fee, your seat will be rejected and your seat will be allotted to the another person. Okay, in second round. So you have to pay 35,000 rupees, those who are from general category, EWS category, OBC or OBC NCL category and PWD category and Kashmiri migrants students. Those who are belong to SC and ST category, you have to pay 17,500 rupees for seat acceptance fee. Okay, after paying your seat acceptance fee, your seat will be confirmed and you will definitely go to college. Just after paying your fee, you will just wait for your offer letter. After paying your seat acceptance fee, it generally take 1.5 weeks minimum and maximum 2 to 3 weeks, or maybe sometime after allotment 2 to 3 days your offer letter will be coming through the mail. Okay, let's if you got IISER Kolkata, then after 1.5 week or after 2-3 days or after 2-3 weeks you will get official email by IISER Kolkata, not joint admission committee. Jack se aapka koi vaasta nahi rahega. If you get offer letter through the your allotted college with official email ID, aapko jo college allot hua hai uske hi official email ID se aapko ek mail aayega, aapka Jack se koi vaasta nahi rahega. After getting your offer letter, you don't need to do you don't need to send Jack, please change my college preference, please change this. Jack can't do anything in this. You have to be directly connection with your allotted college. You have to allotted IISER Kolkata, then you have to send an email IISER Kolkata regarding a lot of queries when you are arrival, when you are set. Basically you don't need to do these kind of things. They can already told you through the mail when your arrival date, when your document verification is happening. Okay. Now comes to second option, accept and float. Let's suppose your preference order is Pune, Kolkata, Bhopal, Mohali, Trivandrum, Tirupati and Berhampur. And in first round you will get IISER Mohali, but you did not want to IISER Mohali, you want to IISER Pune or Bhopal and Kolkata. Top 3 IISERs you want, but you don't want IISER Mohali and Tirupati, Berhampur, no. So accept and float. You must pay, you also must pay 35,000 rupees for seat acceptance fee, and those who are SCST 17,500 rupees you must pay because you have accept your seat. Okay, so in first round you choose your option accept and float. In second round there is a chance you have to get IISER Bhopal or you have to get IISER Mohali, or you have to get IISER Kolkata or you have to get IISER Pune. Otherwise you have allotted as it is college jo aapko actual mein allot hua tha, that means IISER Mohali. Okay, I think you are understand what I am trying to say. If you have any query, please let me know on the comments, Instagram, Telegram, email, where you want. Okay, if you in first round, see, try to understand, in first round you choose accept and float because you getting IISER Mohali, but you want IISER Pune, Kolkata and Bhopal. In second round there is a chance you get Bhopal, Mohali or Kolkata. But in case you didn't get, you have already allotted IISER Mohali, there is no chance to degrade. No, aisa nahi hoga ki tumko wo Mohali ke niche wale pakda denge, Tiruvananthapuram, Berhampur, Tirupati de denge, aisa nahi hai. You have, if you selecting float option, then you have to upgrade. No need to degrade. And till last round, if someone had not satisfied also in second round, they also choose accept and float option, because in second round you have to also 3 option. If you selecting a accept and float in first round, when the second round allotment will happen, you also showing a 3 option: reject, accept and float and accept and freeze. If you choose accept and float, again the same process will happen. If you choose accept and freeze, then as simple, you already pay seat acceptance fee and you freeze the college and you will get the offer letter in while taking some time. Okay, when you choose accept and float again, then some time will happen, it is not possible, then when it is showing now, when it is not possible, then you have to go get only two options: either you reject, either you accept and freeze. There is no option accept and float. And these things happen last year. A lot of students float, and they in the last they are showing only two options: either you reject, either you accept and freeze. Okay, I think you are understand what I am trying to say. Ki accept and freeze and accept and float. What is the differences between? You already know those who are taking drop. They already know ki accept and freeze and accept and float. What I am trying to say. And reject, you mean simple reject your seat. No need to pay seat acceptance fee. Okay. So this is the process of how to participate in the counseling. You don't need to do anything. Just submit your preference order and wait for the round of allotment. When the round of allotment will happen, you just log in your ID password and check allotment college allotment will happen or not. Okay. And don't worry, I will make all the videos how to check allotment, how to fill preference order, something. You don't need to worry about things. I am with you. Okay. Till when you are getting the college. After getting the college, I will guide you how to apply for the internships, how to apply for a lot of opportunities you got. Okay. And those who are coming IISER Bhopal, I will definitely meet you. Okay. This is my last year. After that, I am leaving the college. Basically, I am an alumni. After 1 year, I am passed out in this college. Okay. This is my last year, and I hope you are understand how the counseling will happen. And about the refund policy, if you within the deadline, like someone pay 35,000 rupees or someone pay 17,500 rupees, whatever, and he wants to cancel the seat, he or she wants to cancel the seat. So if you cancel your seat within the deadline, like 11th to 14th of July is the deadline of first round of allotment. So if you cancel before 14, you will get your full refund. It means you will, if you pay 35,000 rupees, if you get refund 35,000 after the deadline, you are able to withdraw your seat. But you are able to withdraw your seat, but some amount will be deducted. Okay. I don't know how much amount will be deducted. I need to check in the policy, but some amount will be deducted, and I think you got 34,000 or 33,000 something rupees you will get refunded. Okay, so these are all the refund policy. I don't think so ki in your mind regarding the counseling any doubt you have. If you have, please let me know on the comment box, DM in Telegram and Instagram, and also you are free to email. I repeat, my email ID amitiser241@gmail.com. Okay, so take care, bye bye, and keep watching my videos, and please subscribe my channel also and follow me on Instagram. Bye bye.